Good morning, students. Hope you all are staying safe at home. Today we will be starting a new chapter of geography, chapter 4, maps. As we have learned about globe and we know how to use it to study the location of continents and oceans, let us learn it in detail. As we know that we use maps and globes to study the representation of Earth. When we study the maps, the people who study the map, they are known as cartographers, and the study of map is known as cartography. Now, maps and globes are having some of the differences. Let us learn about them. A globe is a true model of the Earth, and map, it is two-dimensional representation of the Earth on a flat surface, on a flat paper, or we can say surface. Here, the shape and sizes of a globe are not accurately shown. Okay, here, as because of flattening maps, they often distort the shape and size of continents and countries, and the larger the area the shown on map, it is more of the distorted one because it is on the flat surface. Globes, they are large and very cumbersome to carry around, and maps, they are very convenient to carry and to take it from place to place. Globes cannot be used to study smaller areas in detail, as we can say population growth, crops grown, climate or literacy level. Maps are versatile, okay? We can use it in any way we want, on any of the study or topic we want. So let us learn about maps in detail. As I already told you that it is two-dimensional representation of Earth, it gives us plenty of information about a place such as location, landforms or boundaries. They are collected in form of book which is known as atlas. There are certain types of maps such as physical, political and thematic maps. Physical maps are those which shows us natural features like mountain, plateaus, plains, rivers, sea, continents, oceans, etc. Here the political map shows us about the boundaries of countries and state. Thematic map usually shows us single themes like population, vegetation, industries, roadways, rainfall, etc. Now let us move on to digital maps, as they are very increasingly common. They are electronic maps which are cartographic information, which processes its information electronically, and the output is displayed on an electronic screen such as computer or a smartphone. These maps, they have advantages over paper maps, as they can be assessed to a touch of a button. They can be scalable, they can be converted into from country level to street level or to small map by zooming in or out. They can be updated easily, they can be interactive, they can be used to navigate when we want to reach through a destination. They are more useful rather than we consider as paper maps. So digital resource and digital maps, they both are dependent on the electricity and internet, and because we can say this is a disadvantage that in every of the region, or we can say in every remote area, we cannot access to the network. So this is the only one disadvantage of digital map. Now let us move on to components of maps, as there are three main components of map, that is scale, direction and symbol. Scale is the distance between places on a map, which is much smaller than the real distances, as because the map is very small, it is reduced in size. Distance of map cannot be never, it can be accurate representation, and because of that scales are used. Scale is the ratio of the actual distance between the two places and on a map. So for example, if to show 15 kilometers on a map, a smaller unit like 5 centimeter can be chosen, where 1 centimeter represents 3 kilometers. So by this centimeters, we can express some certain kilometers on map. Most of the maps, they are scaled graphically with the help of graphic scale, and to find accurate distance between two places, they are being measured with a string which is placed on the scale, and distance has been accurately obtained. Maps can either be small scale or a large scale. Small scale maps can be 1 centimeter like 500 kilometers, and large scale maps can be used to mark the scale as 5 cm as 500 meter. So large scale map can give more information than a small scale map. Here there are four main directions as well: north, south, east and west. So capital N, capital S, capital E and capital W are the four main directions which are being used to define the direction on a map, and these are known as cardinal points. There are four other directions also in between these cardinal points, that is northeast, southeast, southwest and northwest. These are known as intermediate points. There is a tool which is known as compass, which is used to find directions, where there is a magnetic needle in between of that, which always points towards the north. So maps can be pointed with the marked arrow N, and this shows the north line. We can also find other directions by using this to locate the places. Now the next is symbols. They are the representation of certain features in a map, which we cannot show everything which is as it is, okay, in reality on the map. It is not possible, and that is why we use symbol to just tell that whatever is being there, we can mark in a small figure or form just to represent it. And these symbols, they are being used worldwide, and these are known as conventional symbols. They are of two main purposes. The one is to convey the information in a very small way without using too many words, and which takes up some more space in the map. And the second reason is that conventional symbols, these are standard around the world. They can be understood by any person which speaks different languages, which belong to different country or with different physical boundaries. No one will face any of the issue in understanding the symbols used on map, as these are standardized. These are used worldwide. Okay. So now the next is colors. They are important symbols in map, as each color, they have the specified meaning, just like conventional symbols, which are being agreed internationally. Colors are also agreed. Like we can say, shades of green are used to represent low-lying land such as plain. Higher elevations are used from light brown to dark brown. Shades of purple are used to show higher elevations. Blue is used to show water bodies. Darker shades of blue are used to show the parts of ocean and sea. Light blue is used to show, we can say, shallow water. Okay. So there are many of the things which is having a specific meaning. Now let us learn about key or legend. As the meaning of symbol and colors which are being used in maps, these are being explained, and this is known as key. Okay, every of the thing which has been explained, like we write the scale inside, we mark the north direction, we write the legend which has been marked, like blue color shows this, brown color shows this, orange color shows this, on the side of the map. Okay, and that is known as key or legend. There is a sketch which is a rough guide to any of the place, like we mark, okay, we many a times, just to show the direction to the friends also of our home, we just show the sketch, okay, we just roughly tell them that what is the direction to reach a particular place. So sketch is a rough guide of any of the place, and it can be of many of the symbols or colors can be used to show that. Plan. The next one is plan. It is a detailed and accurate drawing of a very small area on a large scale. Plans, they are always drawn to a scale, and they give a lot of information about a specific area. We can construct if you have seen sometimes that if there is a house or a building which has been made, the engineers, they construct plans, okay, accordingly they work. So mapping a technology, that is also the next one. As thousands of years ago, there has been certain features which are represented, and maps, they always showed some places or regions. They gave us information, and using latest technologies and tools, it was available at that point of time. So maps, they have been drawn by showing the wall of caves, okay, the textiles, the paper, and on finally we can see maps on digital computers and smartphones. So information which maps carry, or we can say the maps have been made for gathering information, and this process, when we make maps just to gather information, it is known as surveying. experts, surveyors or cartographers, they explore a particular area, they note down their features, they write the measurements, they collect all the information regarding every of the thing which they see there. This, they use this data to create accurate maps and or through software we can say. So this is known as surveying. As in the around mid 20th century, satellite imagery was also being developed, where satellites were mounted with cameras, recorded images of the world from space. So they were used to make more accurate maps. These all are the technologies which are being mapped, and then the information is gathered or the places are being more accurately marked and being studied. So students, with this comes an interesting activity for you all to sketch your house or your locality. You can sketch your locality or your school building or your home, any of the place, and you can use some symbols and colors to just show whatever is there around, and you can create an attractive sketch on your own. Start making sketch, use your creativity. Till then, keep learning and have a good day ahead.